Welcome back to another video. For today's video, I'm going to be doing something a little bit differently. If you've never been here before, hi, my name is Allie and I am a flight attendant here in the United States. I am the mommy of two little boys. I am married and I am also pregnant with my third baby boy. I am due in January. And on my channel, you can find vlogs, lifestyle content, flight attendant content, motherhood content, a little bit of everything. And I show you how I balance being a mom and being a flight attendant. So if that sounds interesting to you, I hope you guys click on that subscribe button, turn on the notification bell, and then also follow me over on my social media. So today I decided I would sit down and talk about some things that maybe you shouldn't do when you go on a plane. So I was just talking about this with one of my friends, and we were talking about the things that we see on an airplane, and we spend a lot of time on airplanes. So there are some things that I just, you know, I said, no, don't do that. I don't always tell passengers that, but I'm just thinking in my head, like, don't do that. But I wanted to share some of those things with you guys, and I hope that you guys enjoy this video. And this video is actually going to be the first video of a mini series that I'm starting here on YouTube, and that is going to be me giving you tips on what not to do, what to do, what to eat, what not to eat, drink, pack, whatever. Just a whole bunch of informational videos for you guys when it comes to traveling. I really want to go ahead and be a little bit more informational too when it comes to you as a traveler, and then also give you a flight attendant's perspective. So I hope that you guys are looking forward to that. Quick disclaimer, if you guys do any of these things, please don't get offended. We are just here to have fun and talk and share some of the things that might help you if you're ever traveling or if you find yourself going on an airplane anytime soon. The first thing I'm going to share with you guys is to not sleep during takeoff and landing. Do not fall asleep. I know that sometimes it's really hard because you're so tired, especially if your trip has been a very early trip and you had to wake up at like 2 a.m. to get to the airport, and then just all the rush of getting through security and all that fun stuff that goes with traveling. So falling asleep during takeoff and landing could also make it harder on your ears, and it might be a little bit painful and cause some discomfort. So if you are like me and suffer from that and you're a little bit sensitive when it comes to pressure in your ears, make sure to avoid falling asleep during takeoff and landing and just chew some gum, yawn, or something like that, and just wait till we're up in the air to take a nap. This second one, my goodness, it is one of the biggest ones, and I cannot stress this one enough. Do not walk around barefoot. Don't walk around barefoot. Think about this. How often do airplanes clean or shampoo the rugs on the plane? Just think about that. Just don't do it. Just don't do it. Do not go into the bathroom barefoot. I have seen it many, many times when people just walk into the bathroom with no socks, no shoes, nothing. And they just walk in like nothing and step on water that's on the floor. I promise you, that is not water. That is next to your foot. So do not walk around barefoot. Put your shoes on just to go to the bathroom. If you need to take them off or something while you're sleeping, just to be a little bit more comfortable, I understand. But do not walk around barefoot. Trust me, it's for your own good. Another thing is, do not keep quiet if you see something that just doesn't look right. So if you see something, say something. Whether you're not feeling well or you see that somebody else is struggling maybe to breathe or to chew their food or something like that, or you see that someone maybe is in distress, let a flight attendant know. Do not stay quiet. Do not stay quiet. I can't tell you how many times it's happened that somebody didn't say something, and you know, we have hundreds of people on board sometimes, and it's really hard to really pay attention to every single thing that's going on around the cabin. So sometimes by passengers bringing things to our attention, we have been able to avoid certain things. So make sure that if you guys see something, say something. Ring your call bell button, let us know, or get up and go to the galley, and trust me, we will take it seriously. The next tip I want to share with you guys is to not rely on the airline for anything that you think you might need during your flight. So this includes entertainment, it includes blankets, it includes a specific type of snack that you want, because one, you never know what may have happened during catering. Catering does tend to get messed up sometimes along the way, and you don't want to be stuck on a plane feeling uncomfortable. Planes can also get really cold sometimes, and from my understanding, correct me if I'm wrong, someone let me know in the comments down below, but unless you're traveling transatlantic, transcontinental, or you're like in first class or business class, you might not always get a blanket. So always bring something to keep yourself warm, because planes do tend to get cold at times. And then also don't rely on the entertainment. Make sure you download something on your phone now that we have Disney Plus and you can download things, Netflix. I think Hulu now you can download stuff. So why not download something before you get on the plane or bring a book or something like that. So don't rely on the airline having entertainment because sometimes the aircraft may not have a TV for you to be able to watch something or entertain yourself while you're on the flight. This last one, I'm a little bit nervous to bring up because I know there's a lot of controversy when it comes to talking about this, but do not bring a suitcase that you cannot carry or lift yourself. Why? I have heard flight attendants say that it's because we're not getting paid while we're boarding, and if they get hurt, then something about workers' comp. I don't know the details of that, and I don't want to say anything wrong, so I'm not even going to mention it. But what I would like to say, and what I have heard from other flight attendants that I've worked with and that have actually gone through this, is that the reason why we are not required and we're actually not allowed to help you with your luggage is, or to carry your luggage, is because if we get hurt in the event of us lifting your luggage, you are now out a flight attendant for your flight. So, let me give you an example. If I hurt myself, I have seen flight attendants that have been lifting a suitcase for a passenger and they have dislocated their shoulders or hurt their shoulders, their back or whatever, and they have had to go and be seen by a doctor. So now that flight doesn't have a flight attendant. There's a specific number of flight attendants that is required to be on a flight at all times. And if you have a flight attendant that is hurt, you are now down a flight attendant. So that flight attendant has to get replaced. And airlines have this thing called reserve where you have flight attendants that are on call. However, now that flight attendant that is going to get called has maybe a 2-hour period or window for them to report to the airport because that is just how it is for reserve. Some airlines have 3 hours, some airlines have 2 hours. So now your flight is delayed because now you're waiting for a flight attendant to come and replace the flight attendant that got hurt because she was lifting someone else's luggage. So make sure that you, if you pack it, you are able to lift your luggage. So that is it for this video. I hope I was able to give you some tips on what not to do when you're on an airplane, and stay tuned for all the other videos that I have coming up on maybe what to do on an airplane. So tips and what to pack, what not to pack and stuff like that. So I hope that you guys stay tuned for that and that you're looking forward to all the new content that is coming up. So make sure you guys are also following me over on my social media. I'll see you guys over in my next video. Bye guys. About to leave, already packing, come with me. I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know. About to see.